Then let's swap all parts. Put out 2 strands of red yarn, and then thread it through the needle. Fix the yarn tail inside the eye fabric in this way. Then embroider some bloody threads on the white part of the eye. You can decide the specific locations and shapes of the bloody threads. Conceal the yarn tail inside the fabric, and finally cut off excess end. The bloody threads are completed. Take a piece of white yarn and thread it through the needle. First, fix the yarn tail inside the fabric. Then embroider highlights in the middle of the eye. You can decide the specific location of the highlights. The highlight is completed. Conceal the yarn tail inside the fabric, and finally cut off excess end. The highlight is completed. Thread the needle with the yarn tail of the eye. Select any edge formed by the front post double crochet of the pumpkin bag as the center. We'll sew the eye fabric on rounds 6 to 10 of the pumpkin. Please finish the rest stitches by yourself. This should be what it looks like when it's done. Conceal the end tail inside the fabric and finally cut off excess end. The eye on the pumpkin bed is completed. Pull out 2 strands of red yarn and then thread it through the needle. First, fix the yarn tail inside the fabric in this way. Leave the yarn tail outside. Then embroider some bloody threads on the white part of the eye. You can decide the specific locations and shapes of the bloody threads. Conceal the end tail inside the fabric and finally cut off excess end. The bloody threads are completed. Make sure the reserved holes of the head on round 18 are located on the left and right side of the bag. We'll sew the eyeball to the front of the head on rounds 2 to 3, keeping it level with the eye on the pumpkin bag. Conceal the entail inside the fabric, and finally cut off excess end. The eyeball and the head are sewn up. Take a piece of white yarn about 1 meter long and thread it through the needle.